other than APA and MLA, which we have covered by this stage, we also have other styles, but these ones are less popular. And the first one is Harvard, and then we also have Chicago Manual of Style, and then we have another one called IEEE. So these ones are not very common in academic writing, but it's just good for you to have them for reference. So in case you ever encounter an assignment which requires you to use them, you will know what to do. So let me just start with Harvard. So Harvard is very similar to APA in many respects. So Times New Roman, size 12, double spacing, they still hold. So the difference might come on the cover page. So you can see the Harvard formatting requires a very specific title page. About halfway down the page is the title of the paper in all capital letters. So I think this is the most distinguishing feature, that the title is in capital letters. In APA, remember, we use title case. Then following this, about three lines down is the name of the author. So about three lines down after the title is the name of the author. This is not in capital letters. You move four lines down and then you put the name of the class, and on the line after that, the name of the professor. Next is the line. Next line is the name of the school, and then the city, and the date. Another difference is the header. So the header contains a short description of the title and a sequential page number. So let us look at the example. So this is an example. So about half we have the title, you can see it's all caps, and then by somebody, then of course name of the class, tutor, university, the city or state, and then the date. So when they're saying about the header, they are saying about this. So you have a small short description. Just you are free to, you are the one responsible for, you know, designing it. So if your title is so long, you just find a small description to describe the paper. So you write here a small description, which is flash right, and then insert the page numbers as usual. Of course the page number will come to the right, top right, as in APA. So in-text citations are the same, so there's no difference. It's still surname and the year. And then on the reference page, that's where another difference comes in, because when you're on Google Scholar, you will not copy APA. For example, you will now copy for Harvard. Remember, it's APA, you're copying APA. So in this case, we'll copy Harvard. So that is all about Harvard, really. I'll share this document, which will guide you further. But there's no much difference between APA and Harvard. So you'll go through this document, plus you can also do your own research online to find a sample of papers, and also you can determine if they have various editions like APA and MLA have, so that you can see what they actually need. I think I noticed another difference is to do with the title. I think they are not bolding. Remember in APA 7 titles were in bold, so that's also something you need to take note of. So you can just freestyle on your own. You can just learn these things on your own. I'll provide you the guide. You can look at it, but you can also go online and look for more, because I just downloaded this from online, so you can also find others. So let us move on to the next style, which is Chicago. So Chicago is very different from MLA and APA. So Chicago Manual of Style. So you can also check out CMS, Chicago Manual of Style, to find their templates, their guidelines, their editions. I don't know which edition they are at now. So you can just check them out. So Chicago style is documented by Chicago Manual of Style, so you can check them out. So the biggest difference is that I don't even know the cover page, but you can find this online. Just go and check for Chicago style sample papers. You'll find many of them online. You can see how, what they include in their cover page, if they have a header and all that. But let me just mention on the in-text citation, because that's where I feel there's a lot there's a big difference. So as opposed to inserting surnames and the year, CMS use superscripts and footnotes. So for example, if you are saying and then you want to quote in APA or APA, Harvard, and MLA, you would insert the surname. So in this case, you don't. You just put a full stop, and then now that you have the article you're referring to, let's say the article you want to cite is this one. So of course, because it's Chicago, you'll pick the Chicago, and then you will copy it. I just copied it. Okay, just copied it. It's in my clipboard. And then normally would be inserting the surnames, you know, Kusa. And then maybe for APA, 1993. For MLA, we'll be putting these page numbers. So for Chicago, just put a full stop and then go to references on your menu ribbon and then click insert footnote. Once you click insert footnote, it will automatically open the footer. And then you can just paste whatever you copied, the reference you copied from Google Scholar. So it inserted here ka one, which is ka superscript, which corresponds with this reference. So when you continue writing, so here I want to quote another person, so I'll just put my full stop, and then I will get the reference that I want to place. So let me say I want to pick this one. So remember to also pick for Chicago, don't pick another reference. So you'll pick Chicago, so you'll just copy that in your clipboard, and then you just say insert footnote. So it will put superscript number two, and then you just paste it there. So it have that number two. So when you're continuing to write within this page still, when you are still writing, maybe let's say I'm just trying to figure out what I can write. I'm just trying to demonstrate this, but at this level you know what I'm talking about when writing, you know, when writing down points. So let me just say something. So I want to insert another citation, and the citation I'm inserting is the same one, that it's the same as number one, it's still Kusa. So I'll just insert my footnote, but I'll not copy paste the full thing here, the full, because it's just filling out space. So you can just write there Kura, just that. The reader will know this is referring to the same as this, so you don't have to copy paste this back again, because it will just fill up your space. So you can do that whenever you are repeating the same citation in the same page. Don't paste it several times, just write the surname alone. But that only applies if it's in this page. When I want to cite Kusa in another page, I'll have to put the full. But as long as I'm still citing these people within this page, I don't need to constantly paste the full citation, and just use the short form, which is Nevona. So if it's there are different pages you are quoting, you can just say Kuva, it's Kurar. Maybe the first one was page 259, and this one is page 3. Let me say 260. So you can just say Kura P 260. Which means now this one was on different page and this one is different page. If you are quoting number four again, you can just continue using Kurar page and then separate by page. numbers. So that is all about Chicago. So you notice now that you have all the references here, you may not really need a reference page, but you can just go and check this out if it's necessary to have another reference page at the bottom. But I believe now that you have references in every page, it doesn't make sense to have now another separate reference page. So that's all about Chicago. I think in their thinking, they figured having these names within the text, they just interrupt your reading. They interrupt your reading. Maybe you are reading and then the name that is placed in the quotation in the brackets there in jina ya ex wako. So inafanya unamkumbuka unakasirika. Alafu sasa unaanza kupoteza line ya thought when ulikuwa unasoma. Maybe it's a name that brings about many memories and they just sort of kick you off track and you have to start reading that paragraph all over again. So they realize that most readers don't need those, don't go to citations anyway. Most readers will not go to confirm this. And placing these names here might interrupt the reading process and throw you off guard a little bit. So they say, okay, let's just put superscripts and then to avoid all that. So that is all about CMS. I'll share samples and you can also read more online. These things are available online, so you'll find them there. The next style is called IEEE. I'm not even sure what that means, but I understand it's common for engineering classes. I don't know, let me just check what this means. I've never really cared to understand what it means. Yeah, Institute of Electrical and Electrical Engineers. Yeah, it's something to do with engineering. So most engineering assignments will be using IEEE. I'm really not interested about their cover page because I know you can find this online very easily. Let me just mention about their in-text citations. So it's similar to CMS Chicago. The only difference is that instead of putting superscripts and using footnotes, you just put placeholders. So let's try this. Let me just say Kenya is one. I like using this because I understand we are very corrupt though in Africa. So I want to quote someone. So I'll just put these block brackets, little box. If you open that, put number one, close, and then you close, and then you pick that reference that should be your first one on the list. So you just open another page, then you go to Google Scholar, and then funny thing, you realize that Google Scholar does not have IEEE. They have MLA, APA, Chicago, Harvard, and Harvard. They don't have IEEE. So what you do, you can just pick I've seen the IEEE style looks pretty much like MLA. They are references, so pick MLA, but you can find that I think other databases will have other citation generators might have this. So just pick just go ahead and pick MLA and then you put it on your page. That is the first one, so that will be the first, and then you continue writing. So you continue writing, maybe so here I want to quote somebody else, so I'll put number two. Then you pick that reference. Let's say now it was this article. You'll pick for the MLA because I think zinafanana. Sijaona waja produce Google Scholar jaunda ya IEEE, so ndaeka hiyo. So maybe nikiendelea kuandika, I want to quote back the article that is number one. So utaweka tu number one, utaweka number three because una refer to article number one. So So hapa I'm still quoting the first source, the first article. So I'll just put one. And already I have my one here, so I won't put, because I put three and then I repeat this, it doesn't make sense. So I'll just put one to refer to this. And then on your reference page, you do not arrange them alphabetically. Leave them the way they are. And then you will now carry them to your document, to your paper at the bottom. I don't know if they call it references or works cited, you can confirm, and then you paste them. And then you now list them, right? This was number one. Then I've seen them, they sort of just tab everything else. This was number two. I'm just tabbing. Yeah, so that's how you list them. So you don't arrange them alphabetically. You just naziandika number one, number two, it's not appear hapa. So whenever you want to refer to article number two, utaandika tu number two kwa index citation, number two. So you don't evo. Kama uko na tatu unaweka tu hivyo. So this is how your reference list will look like. So that is all about it. In case you have questions, you can just engage. But remember, you don't put a different number for the same reference. Okay? For when you're referring to a swani within that document, kama a swani ilikuwa number three, it will be number three all through. If it was number one, itakuwa number one all through. In different kiasi na Chicago, Chicago unaweka a different superscript number for every citation, regardless kama ni the same ama si same. So I'm confused. Kama una confused, uta rewind ama uta rewind hii video, urudi nyuma uone za Chicago, and then ukuja hapo compare na hii. The difference is Chicago, they create a number, a different superscript number, zinaendelea hivyo for every citation, regardless of whether it's the same or not. But for IEEE style, same references zinapewanga namba moja. So reference hii article ya hii mse, anywhere zinaapia, utaziita, utazipatia number one tu kwa hiyo document. That is the difference. So I hope that is clear. So that's all about these three other styles.